Hello Voxelnauts! Let's get familiar with VoxEdit's animated template mode. I recommend checking out the Introduction to VoxEdit and its Modeler Mode videos in this playlist if you haven't used the program before. VoxEdit automatically downloads the latest template files whenever you open the Animator tab. These files are created by our animation team in the Sandbox Creator Fund, and they're designed to work perfectly with the Sandbox Game Maker. Click on the template you want to start using, and VoxEdit will prompt you to create a project folder where the rig, animation, model, and thumbnail files will be saved. Once the files are created, we will be in the template mode of the animator, which removes access to anything that could change the animations or rigging. This is designed to help new users create fun animated assets without being able to break the way the animations work. The skeleton panel on the left shows how the rig is constructed, and you can even show the rig with this button to see it in the 3D view. The bounding box button is helpful to see how objects will be able to collide with your figure. You do have full access to the library panel, where you can delete, duplicate, import, and edit any voxel models you want. If you want to try designing different heads, you can create multiple object files and drag them to the head node in the skeleton panel to switch between them. You can also unlink objects from the nodes with the three-dot menu if you do not want that node to be in your design. The timeline panel can select the different template animations and play them to check that your design works well. Now to edit the models, you can use the pencil buttons on the skeleton panel or the library. The skeleton option will display the rest of the rig as a ghost image for reference. The library option is helpful for objects that are not yet attached to the rig. In the modeler, you have access to the full tool set. You can color and model on the template file, or you can erase everything and start from scratch. When you're done modeling, press the home button to save and go back to the animator. To keep colors consistent across my figure, I find it helpful to start with a pre-made palette that I can load from the menu. Or if I'm experimenting with different colors, I can save the palette when I'm done with the first object, then load the saved palette when I start on the second one. As I add more colors, I will save and load again with each new object. If significant changes are made to the model geometry, you might need to adjust the pivot point. This is most helpful when you can see the rest of the rig's ghost, so you can line up the joint correctly. Small adjustments to the template pivots often work fine, but making changes that are too big can easily break the animations, with joints separating in terrifying ways. As of April 2020, there isn't an official way to open a template in the full animation editor. Some have done it by accident through glitches, or discovered other ways of modifying their files, but there's a risk that forcing this could break your files or cause lost work. It is possible that this will be supported in the future, though. As you're designing, keep in mind that VoxEdit optimizes its files by combining rectangular areas into a single face, or a pair of two triangles. Every bump or non-rectangular plane will add additional faces and twice as many triangles. The Sandbox Marketplace and Game Maker currently only officially support models with up to 5,000 faces or 10,000 triangles. Objects that are super detailed, like my giant lizard monster, will not be possible to upload to the marketplace. Finding ways to square rounded areas into blockier shapes helps reduce the face count and match the sandbox style better. If you're looking for help with VoxEdit or feedback on your artwork, we have a huge community on Discord that is happy to help. Link in the description. I'm excited to see what creative ways you figure out how to use the animated templates in VoxEdit. If this video got you excited to start creating your own animated characters, give it a big thumbs up, subscribe, and ring the bell for more tutorials on modeling and animating in VoxEdit. Thanks for watching.